Hello and welcome to Soul Food. Soul Food will be integrating the Proverbs, as we had in A Pause for Proverbs, but also will incorporate scriptures from other books of the Bible to encourage and nourish our souls. You know, we spend a great deal of time tending to our physical body. Great attention is given to the foods we put in and the exercise we perform. We also spend considerable time choosing our clothing, doing our hair, and making sure we are presentable to others. Our outside appearance is important to all of us, but no matter how fit, how fabulous, and how fancy we appear on the outside, if our souls aren't fed the right food, we suffer. What is healthy food for the soul? Well, let's start with gratitude. Colossians says to be thankful always, and that our life should be full of thanks to Him. Harvard Health shares that gratitude helps people feel more positive emotions, relish good experiences, improves their health, deals with adversity, and builds strong relationships. Sounds like something I'd want in my life. Number two is kindness. Proverbs says that kind words are like honey, sweet to the soul. And Ephesians says to be kind and compassionate to one another. According to research from Emory University, when you are kind to another person, your brain's pleasure center actually lights up, as if you were the recipient of the good deed. This is called the helper's high, or as I like to call it, a two-for-one gift. Laughter is a great soul food and often overlooked because we believe it to be unimportant. But Proverbs tells us that a cheerful heart does good, like a medicine. And research shows that laughter lowers blood pressure, reduces our pain, relaxes our muscles, increases our energy, and inspires hope. All the things I would like to find in my life. Lastly, the most important soul food is love. The best definition I have found about love was written by a six-year-old named Emma. She says that love is when you're missing some of your teeth, but you're not afraid to smile because you know you're still loved, even though some of you is missing. That's exactly the way God loves us. So the next time your soul is hungry, feast on the things that will fill your soul: kindness, gratitude, laughter, and love. These things will make you feel full and satisfied. Have a great week.